any kind of revenue themselves. And that's obviously going to lead to nothing but confusion. Does that mean ad revenue? Does that mean actual income? Does that mean, you know, anyone who has a donor page or something like that? What does that actually mean? So Bill C-11 will also change the relationship that social media companies have with their users. The government will be able to require social media companies to promote certain types of content, and in doing so are automatically, obviously, also suppressing and reducing exposure to other kinds of content as well. Another concern is the big benefits for traditional media organizations. Now, Bill C-11 tilts strongly in favor of more traditional media interests and against more innovative online-only types of media organizations. And that could be news media, that could be movie streaming, that could be music streaming, whatever. And it's worth noting that the large traditional producers and broadcasters are largely in favor of the legislation and actively promoting it. So I think the cable-cutting generation is one that alarms these companies, and the government is promising regulations to ensure that these traditional media sources are competitive once again by seriously handicapping the internet. Now, Michael Geist is one of Canada's foremost experts in this area and a vocal critic of this bill, and he points out that the government is intentionally helping traditional media. Here we go. Here's what he says, quote, "Broadcasters such as Bell and the CBC were already vocal proponents of the bill. When the minister responsible, the heritage minister responsible for regulating the sector, calls on the same sector to lobby his government and the Canadian public in support of his own legislation, the wall between regulated and regulator is obliterated, end quote. Now, obviously, that's a conflict of interest here that we should be concerned about. So what's the impact on Christian organizations and Christian producers? Well, there's something interesting to note here that I didn't notice in any of the other critics, but there's an inclusion here of language that includes things like gender expression and more in the bill, and it raises questions about how far the government and the regulatory body would be willing to go in regulating faith-based content creators or others that it disagrees with. Bill C-11 adds the following wording to the Broadcasting Act, quote, "Through its programming and the employment opportunities arising out of its operations, it must serve the needs and interests of all Canadians, including Canadians of diverse sexual orientations, gender identities and expressions, and reflect their circumstances and aspirations, including equal rights," end quote. So this gives the CRTC the power to promote and regulate content that provides the potential, I think, for suppressing certain types of content, right? Suppressing organizations, let's say, that defend preborn rights, that might be different from the way that the government looks at some of these issues, or maybe the way that your church talks about sexuality and gender or the family that might disagree with the government's stance on this. And what the government doesn't seem to understand is that the tools that it has, the tools at its disposal, are tools of prohibition, regulation, and restriction, and that those are primarily negative tools, not positive ones. And so I think that it will almost certainly make restrictions on freedom of expression likely as a result of this bill. Now, Bill C-11 could foreseeably apply to the quote-unquote broadcasts of organizations, of Christian organizations like ARPA Canada and others, any Christian organizations that produce any sort of content for the internet, digital content. There's also nothing exempting churches or other faith-based organizations from being considered broadcasters. Remember, the exemption is only for individuals who are not making any money off their production. And the question is, does it apply to organizations? Well, yes, it does. There's no exemptions. So the reality is that they're claiming some level of control over all internet content. And so your sermon audio feed could be subject to the same kinds of broadcasting rules as your local radio station. So Bill C-11 gives too much power to the CRTC over the internet. It discriminates against the individual and small content creators. It puts pressure on social media companies to suppress or promote certain types of content and subjects faith-based content creators to the scrutiny of the Canadian government. So, conclusion, it needs to be opposed. So what can be done? Well, ARP is working on, we've actually produced now an easy mail for you to use to let your member of parliament know that you do not support this bill and would like to see them vote against it. We're also working on several other action items that will be related to this. The regulation of internet content in this way by changing the Broadcasting Act will result in a reduction of freedom of expression and will certainly unfairly pressure individual and small up-and-coming content producers. So you can go to arpacanada.ca for more.
Shalom. Koholo Yahobashim El Shah, Bashim, Wakakadai, Samansa the Apostles, Devansa the Elders, the Great Millstone, Ruel, and Tosh's Truth. Much respect to you brothers out there as preaching his word and truth and sincerity throughout the four corners of earth. Tabernacle David, hope for like and a speckled bird. I want to say shalom. So let's get right into it. So as you've seen, pretty much that bill that is being passed in Canada, or will be passed, all right, because you got a lot of people opposing it. You know, just keep your eye out. You know, as we know, we're getting closer and closer to the end. And this man, Esau Edom, wants us up off the internet and off the streets, man. You know, so those that have the eyes to see can see very clear. You know, bills like these are pretty much really gearing up to get the Israelites off the internet. All right? But that's all right. Because whoever was meant to get this truth is meant to get it. You know, hey, if these bills to come, or this bill, all right, just know, if a bill like this is being passed in Canada, all right, because a lot of times what happens in one country eventually comes over here to Babylon the Great, and it comes even harder here, all right? Like one plague, like the plague happened in other countries, and then the plague hit hard here, Slacking, just stuff like that, man. Just get right into it, you know. So just be out, you know, watching, keeping up. All right, because we know we're getting nearer and nearer to the end of this thing, and hey, the Lord is about to shut down this place. So be prepared to see bills like this being passed here in Babylon the Great to get us off the internet or to suppress this truth. But like I said earlier, who's ever meant to get this truth is meant to get it, man. All right? Who's ever meant to get this truth was meant to get it. Everybody else is blinded. So let's get a couple scriptures, and we'll go ahead and close out. This is 2 Corinthians 2:11. Least Satan should get an advantage on us, for we are not ignorant of his devices. We are not ignorant of Satan's devices. Bills like this that's being passed in Canada, and pretty much future bills, be on the lookout. Future bills that will be passed is to get us off the internet, to get us off of YouTube or social media or whatever, man, for us not to push this word. All right, why? Because we don't agree with the views of Babylon the Great. All right, we're contrary, just like this man Esau Edom, who's a so-called white man, is contrary to the word of Yahweh Shemel Shah. We're contrary to the ways of this man Esau Edom in Babylon the Great. Okay, and so they want to suppress this truth. They want us, hey, they really want us out so they can prolong their kingdom. All right, because I got a lesson queued up that I want to do. Hey, they know Sodom and Gomorrah was real. They know these kingdoms were real. And so as you read in the scriptures, you know, Sodom and Gomorrah was given as an example to those that live after that lifestyle. If you live after that lifestyle, you will be destroyed. Okay? Let's get some more scripture. This is 2 Corinthians 4:4-3. But if our gospel be hid, it is hid to them that are lost. See? Because the Lord doesn't want everybody to get this truth. Right? Hey, this truth right here is a privilege to have, man. This is truly a privilege and a blessing to have. And the Lord doesn't want all of our people to have it, man. And whom the God of this world, who's that? As Esau Edom. Earth is given into the hand of the wicked. And our people worship this man. You know, a lot of our people out there in the Christian church as well. Who are they worshiping? Caesar Borgia. Alright. Have blinded the minds of them which believe not, least the light of this glorious gospel of Mashiach, who is the image of power, should shine unto them. And it's not going to shine unto them because the Lord doesn't want everybody to get this truth. All right? This is Amos 8:11. Behold, the days come, saith the Lord Yahweh Shemel Shah, that I will send a famine in the land, not a famine of bread, nor of thirst for water, but of hearing the words of the Lord Yahweh Shemel Shah. Now, don't get it twisted. That famine of bread and water is coming. But the most important famine that's really going to hit this place is that wisdom, that knowledge and understanding. All right? people going to be bugging out. People are going to be looking for answers, and they're not going to get it. As we'll read, they shall wander from sea to sea, from the north even to the east. They shall seek. They shall run to and fro to seek the word of the Lord and shall not find it. In that day shall the fair virgins and young men faint for thirst. All right. So they're going to be looking for us, looking for that truth, looking for that wisdom. And they're not going to get it. And the people that they do, you know, so-called get wisdom from, they ain't got it, man. Hey, they're going to know that their pastors, their grandpa, their grandmother, you know, all that bull crap that they were feeding them was not right. Matthew 24 and verse 14, but if this gospel, Slaki, and this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached in all the world for a witness unto all nations, and then shall the end come. You see the men out there on the highways and byways preaching this word and doing our lessons, right? This word has been heard, all right? And so we're seeing the rapid decline of Babylon the Great right before our very eyes, okay? And a lot of people have heard about this truth and know about this truth, okay? A lot of people have no excuse that they have not heard. Amos 5 and verse 13, therefore the prudent shall keep silence in that time, for it is an evil time. That time is very, it's coming very, very soon. When all hell breaks loose, hey, best believe. When we're not able to go out there on the highways and byways, a lot of you Jakes are not going to get that truth. They're going to be looking at you like, hey. We don't comprehend. We don't know what you're talking about, man. I'm going to get these last two scriptures. I'm going to close out right here. This is 2 Ezra 6 and verse 27. For evil shall be put out. We waiting for that. And deceit shall be quenched. We waiting for that. That's why we hastening the coming of Yahweh Shemir Shai. As for faith, it shall flourish. Corruption shall be overcome. And the truth, which have been so long without fruit, shall be declared, and they're going to know. All right, these people that doubted us, that looked down upon us, called us bums, called us every other name under the sun, they're going to realize who had the truth and who didn't. All right? Read that Wisdom Solomon 5, man. And they're going to see the man of the Lord with their spiritual power, man of the Lord getting beamed up. And they're going to be wishing that they listened, that they took heed, all right? But that's pretty much it, man. Like I said, bills like, hey, expect bills like this to be passed here in Babylon the Great to try to get us off the internet or to try to suppress this truth. But, hey, the damage is already done. Whoever is meant to get this truth is meant to get it. So I'm in right there. Shalom.